Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Genelec Immersive Audio video series. My name is Eric, and in the second episode, we're going to talk about immersive speaker setups and how they scale to your room. Let's start. All right, let's talk a little bit about the scalability of the speaker setups to your room. Now, first of all, we have to check what is my or your application. So which format are you willing to install into your room? Is it, for instance, Dolby Atmos? Then your theatrical setups can have up to 64 speakers feed, as already learned in the first episode. But the typical speaker setup for an Atmos home setup is 714 or 914. When you look at Oro 3D, same consideration. How big is your room? How many speakers do you want to mount? Is it somewhere between 9.1 and 13.1? Now, because Dolby Atmos is at the moment the commercially most successful immersive audio format, the following slides are dedicated more into Atmos production environments. When we look at the room sizes and the mixing position, these are critical things to consider. First of all, we have to determine how big is our layout. And the layout is calculated by the distance between the center speaker in the front and your furthest rear surround speakers. So that's your layout length. Your layout width is calculated by the distance of your side surround speakers from each other. And then you have the layout height, which is recommended to be 2.4 meters or higher. The speaker distance should not exceed 5 meters, although something below 4 meters is recommended for Atmos home environment. Otherwise, you would sit too much into the midfield and you would get too much reverberation information from the room. Unless you're sitting in a theatrical cinema with horn speakers, but that's a different topic. Now, how to choose the correct speaker for your application? First of all, how far away are you listening or sitting, basically? What's your listening distance? And then, does the format, in this particular case, Dolby Atmos, does it require any special sound pressure level values? So how loud shall the speaker be at your mixing position? For theatrical applications in Dolby Atmos, your speakers have to be or have to reproduce 105 dB SPL at the listening position. And that's quite a lot. For Dolby Atmos Home, the recommended SPL requirement or SPL value at the listening position from the front speakers is 99 dB SPL. And for all surrounds, it's 96 dB SPL. And then another consideration that comes into my mind, into your mind when it comes to speaker choose is, you want to choose a two-way speaker, a three-way speaker, or maybe a three-way coaxial speakers. All those speakers have different approaches and can be used in one way or another to accommodate immersive audio installations, but we're going to cover this a little later. When it comes to choosing the speakers for Dolby Atmos, there is a tool available that's called the DARDT, the Dolby Atmos Room Design Tool, which is a very handy tool where you can dial in your layout length, width, and height, and you can also dial in your mixing position. That can easily help you to find the correct speakers that would work in your certain environment. Of course, all the Genelec models are listed in the start as well, so it's going to be easy to pick and choose the right model for this application. When it comes to the positioning of speakers, it's actually not that difficult as we all think. Basically, Dolby Atmos is following the ITU recommendations about speaker placement on a circle around the listener, and it's exactly the same. So the front speakers will be mounted, same as in stereo, somewhere between 22 and 30 degrees out of your middle angle. The center, of course, is not angled and will be placed right in the middle in front of you. The side surrounds, there's a little window between 90 degrees and 110 degrees. To your listening position where you can mount the speakers. And this window is important because sometimes you have a door in the studio or there's a window or something at exactly that listening position. So that's why it is pretty handy that you can move the speakers slightly towards the front or towards the rear. You can even lift it up a little bit. The back surrounds, there's a window of 135 up to 150 degrees. Where you can mount them. And for the top speakers, it's actually pretty simple. You draw a line from your listening position up to the ceiling, then you fold 45 degrees to the front, 45 degrees to the back, and from that one, even 45 degrees to left and right. That's where you put your speakers. Very simple. But there is also a window in between. You can choose the angle, and this is important because when you go to the lower value, so towards 45 degrees or even 40 degrees, it can be considered as okay for Dolby Atmos, but interesting is that you then come into a window where Oro 3D height layers are actually mounted. So basically, there is a possibility to install speakers to accommodate both formats, and that's a good thing. So when it comes to speaker positioning, we draw a couple of examples here. So for instance, this is a drawing for an 18 square meter room with a listening distance of 1.7, 1.8 meters. We have a layout length of 3.7 meters, a width of 3.4, and a height of 2.6. It is a very basic, often used room size. And when you put those values into the Dolby Atmos room design tool, for instance, the 8331, which is our smallest member of the coaxial three-way, the One series, could come in very handy for this particular application with a little 12-inch sub, for instance. So, and this is just to give you an example how this can be calculated. The next room size is slightly bigger. It's a 29 square meter room, which is like a decent mixing stage already, a home cinema mixing stage, with a layout length of 5 meters, a width of 4.2 meters, 2.7 meters in the height, roughly 2 meters listening distance. And then our 8351B model would fit perfectly for the front speakers. And the side, back, and top surrounds can be used with the 8341s. Just to give you a rough example, how this room design tool from Dolby actually translates to a real-world environment and an example. When it comes to the speaker scalability to your particular room, Genelec has a big offering of different models in the portfolio, from the smallest two-way speakers over the ones, which is a three-way coaxial speaker setup design, up to the biggest in-wall flush mount speakers with 2x18-inch woofers, for instance. So a very big range of products that can also be combined one with another, depending on the need and also on the SPL requirements of the particular immersive audio format. And everything is also kind of handed with a nice arrangement of different subwoofers. What's good about all these products is all these products have the SAM technology. So those products are smart active monitors and can be calibrated and adapted to your acoustic environment. Why is that so important? Now think about immersive audio applications. You don't have stereo speakers anymore that shoot sound from the front into your room. You have to be able to place speakers all around you, and every speaker is interacting and engaging with the room from a different angle and a different perspective. So it's very critical that room acoustics are made for immersive audio environments and are kind of adapted. And everything else can then be calibrated using the SAM speakers and the GLM technology. GLM stands for Genelec Loudspeaker Manager, and this is our method to adapt the speakers to the acoustical environment. Very critical for immersive audio applications is that every speaker is calibrated, not only the frequency response at the listening position, which should be as flat as possible. GLM takes care of a level balancing of the speakers to each other and also takes care of the time of flight calculation, which means it's delaying speakers depending on how far or how near they are to the listening position. So at the end of the day, all speakers reach the listening position at the same time with the same volume and hopefully as flat as possible. The GLM setup is very easily set up. Basically, it contains of a network adapter, which is connected via USB to your computer. And from there, you run an Ethernet cable daisy chain from one speaker to the other. The calibration microphone is also connected to the GLM network adapter. This whole setup can accommodate up to 80 speakers, which should be enough for most of our immersive audio applications. But it actually can be considered for the biggest ambisonics domes installations, for instance. And if needed, there is a little volume controller that makes GLM to a fully functional monitor controller for immersive audio applications. Now, when we talk about the ONE speakers in particular, Our compact three-way coaxial speaker range is very suitable for immersive audio applications. First of all, due to the design, they can be used as ultra near-field monitors. So if you have very narrow spaces, very small studios or an OB van or something, and are looking for a three-way full-range speaker system, the ones can really deliver super high performance even in an ultra near-field environment. Some more advantages when it comes to immersive audio with the ones are, for instance, that they can be mounted horizontally and vertically at the same time or without any disadvantage, because we have a very controlled directivity and we can deliver the same directivity in the horizontal and in the vertical position. For instance, you have a TV in front of you and need to mount a speaker under the TV. It can be laid flat, for instance, and it offers the exact same performance. Although another interesting topic for the ones is that the phantom source is in between two speakers, the localization is really, really, really precise. So that adds a lot of benefits, especially to immersive audio environments where you have speakers hanging all around you. It's a pin-sharp localization of sound sources. That is really important to mention here. When it comes to mount the speakers in your mix room, Genelec is offering a very big range of accessories. So no matter where you need to place a speaker in your room or in your OB van or in your studio, we do have ceiling mounts, truss mounts, wall mounts, all kind of mounting options are actually available to hang and hold the speaker in the desired and needed position. With this information, I let you go for today. I hope you found this useful. Again, if you have any questions or need any more information about this, please navigate to genelec.com, check for the Immersive Hub, send us an email to immersive.helpdesk@genelec.com, and we're always more than happy to help you on this. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye-bye.